really beautiful. Look at this shot. Ah, we got the sun. Love the sunshine. Yeah, that song's gonna be happening at some point, I hope. I really, really hope. But I have to get some friends together for that. And I'll have to figure out how to do that in the time of COVID. Anywho, I came here today with a very important message. Surprise, surprise. I hope that bus isn't too loud. If it is, sorry, I can't turn it off. So, as I've been going through the motions and doing the work, figuring out the hell I'm doing with my life, the more I connect in, the more I go inward, the more I meditate, the more I pray, the more I am quiet, the more I journal, the more I listen, the more clear I am becoming. And not just thought process-wise. Okay, that's a little much now. There, that's good. It's not quite as dramatic. A little bit of lens flare, a little bit of Jerry Bruckheimer magic. Oh well. The more I get quiet and listen and allow icky stuff to come out of me, the more I am being revealed. The real me. The me that I have felt is there my entire life. Ever since I was a child, I always felt like I had a superpower. I don't know if anybody else felt this way, but I did. I felt like I was one of the X-Men, and at some point my powers were going to reveal themselves in some big magical way. Not that I would have like laser eyes or I could fly, although I'm still holding out hope for that one. But no, there was just, I always felt like there was something inside me and I was just waiting for it to come out. And as a child, I was very bold and very brave and very expressive. As a small child, and then somewhere in my elementary years, it started to get quieter and quieter. My own voice got quieter, my sense of power got quieter, and that belief that I had a superpower became much more of like a longing desperation than an intrinsic belief. And these feelings of self-doubt and fear when it comes to myself and my own capabilities, they've been holding on for a long time. There have been times when they've gone away, when I've done something really cool or went for something I really wanted, but when it comes to really, really like grabbing hold of my life and creating this massive, just magical experience for myself and for my loved ones, I always hit a block. I always hit a roadblock. I only take myself so far, and then resistance hits. And since we've been in the middle of this pandemic, I've had a lot of time to address these things, a lot of time to really go in and figure out, where is this all coming from? I want it gone. And within the past couple of weeks, I want to say, I'm starting to see it. I'm starting to have those feelings again. They're getting stronger. This sense of just incredible power inside me, this sense of confidence and self-assuredness that yes, the magical life is meant for me. I am meant to be here at this time and place to do big things, to do great things, not just for myself, but for humanity. And it's time to put my fucking crown on. And there's still some resistance. As I'm talking about this, I can feel it bubbling up and telling me to shut my mouth and go back to what's comfortable and go back to what's easy. But I cannot anymore. And this is the bigger message that's going on right now. We are coming to a great split, where those of us who are able to get quiet and listen and hear those messages from the universe, from God, however you believe, when we are able to get quiet and hear those messages, we can connect to a power greater than we could ever imagine. And it's time. It's time for all of us to stop hiding and start living in our absolute purest light. It's time for all of us to remember who we are as divine beings on this planet, who we are as spirits having a human experience, who we are as masterpieces. We are pieces of the master. I'm getting goosebumps just talking about this. We are here for such a time as this. Everything that's happening right now is no accident. This pandemic is no accident. All of the evil we are seeing pop up in the world, it's not new. The world is not getting worse. We are just noticing it more. And I want you to realize, and I want you to appreciate the magnitude of what's happening right now in this moment in time. The tragedy of it all is palpable, but the beauty is undeniable. We have a chance to change course, but we have to choose it. And the way we choose it is by connecting to our pure inner light. Get quiet, go within however you need to. If you need to go in nature, if you need to pray, if you need to meditate, if you need to dance, if you need to sing, if you need to shout, then do it. But it's time to wake up and realize that the old ways are gone. Everything that we're seeing popping up and coming to the surface is so that it can be healed, so that it can be changed, so that it can be torn down to make way for something new. And it's time to get our heads out of our asses and stop wallowing in the misery of it all. To connect to our love, connect to our compassion, and make real changes. It's time to get serious. It's time to buckle down. It's time to make real plans, because the world is changing. The world has changed. There's no going back. We're not going back to the way things used to be, and it's time we accept that and start asking ourselves, what's next? What now? Since this way is gone, who do I want to be? Who do I want to become? What parts of me do I want to embrace? What parts of me do I want to let go? How can I show up fully, unabashedly, unapologetically as my full and beautiful, bright, bold, brave self? How can I show up? Where can I be supportive? Where can I lift others up? Where can I be of service? What are my gifts? What are my talents? How can I use them to make this new world better than the old? It's time to step into our power. It's going to take each one of us to really look at ourselves and start making changes in our own lives. How can we be better? How can we be better humans? How can we be better humans and come together as one? Not everybody's going to join the party, and that's okay. It's going to happen. There is a great divide happening, and those who are willing to look inward and clear out the parts of themselves that don't belong in this new time, those are the people that are going to move forward. The people that are still clinging to the old paradigm, those people who just can't let go of the old world and don't see anything that needs changing, it's okay. It's okay. We have to let them go. We have to let them do what they're going to do. We can't change other people. The only people we can change are ourselves. And it's time to wake up. It's time to grow up. It's time to stand up and rise up. I am ready. I'm ready to show up in the way that feels right for me, and I am learning what that is. I'm still listening, always listening. It's time. It's really time.
Every inch of me is trembling, and not from the cold. Something is familiar, like a dream I can reach but not quite hold. I can sense you there, like a friend I've always known. I'm arriving, and it feels like I am home. I have always been a fortress, cold secrets deep inside. You have secrets too. You don't have to hide. Show yourself. I'm dying to meet you. Show yourself. It's your turn. Are you the one I've been looking for all of my life? So certain, all my life I've been torn, but I'm here for a reason. Could this be the reason I was born? I have always been so different. Normal rules did not apply. Is this the day? Are you the way? I finally.
Time.